Barcelona got exactly what they needed. A come-from-behind, highly contested win. Messi chips in with a hat trick of assists. And will Barcelona ever get an obvious penalty called? So happy to see Barcelona beats Real Betis 3-2. In a game that they were behind two times, but were able to pull off the win. Barcelona started off with a new formation for pretty much a consecutive game. Quique Setién is the coach. I believe it was a 4-4-2. Could have been a, I don't know, 4-3-3. Could have been a 4-1-2-1-2. Not really sure, to be honest. New lineup of players as well. So you had Junior Firpo on the left going against his old team. Lenglet and Umtiti started as center back. Right fullback was Nelson Semedo. You had Busquets, De Jong, Vidal, Sergio Roberto, Messi, and Griezmann. Now this game started off very fast. The movement was good. There was a lot of pressure on the ball. Real Betis is no joke. They really are a good team. But Barcelona fought their way through this one. And this is what I talked about last game. They needed to have a coming together game where they all played together, they pushed their hearts out, and they got a win, building on their confidence. So I'm not sure exactly what Sergio Roberto played, but when he's up top, he's not really a threat, unfortunately. But Messi was able to get it by playing what looked like a false nine, dropping into the middle and creating opportunities for others. So around the fifth minute, though, Barcelona went down. You see, it was what they called a hander off of Lenglet. His arm was outside the body. It was unintentional, but it was still a goal. So they get down 1-0 real quick, but Barcelona didn't stop. They didn't give up right there. They kept fighting. And De Jong had one of the best goals of the season, for sure. So in the ninth minute, Messi plays it from, I don't know, about 35 yards out, chip the ball over the line, through ball run from De Jong. Takes it off his chest, hammers it home. 1-1, the game is on. Things are going well. And I really like De Jong was really attacking the ball. He was trying to get up top. He was trying to do through runs, and that was working very effectively. So we're thinking, okay, tied 1-1, let's keep the pressure on. Boom, 27th minute hits. Junior Firpo was playing the ball into Arturo Vidal. Not going to say it was the best pass, but a better touch from Vidal and he would have held on to the ball. Unfortunately, that ball got away from him. Bad touch. And they transitioned in and got a goal. Okay? So, then it's 2-1. Barcelona's behind again. You're thinking, come on, guys. They're trying to play out of the back a lot. Starting in the middle of the game or at the beginning of the game, they're playing out of the back very sloppy. I understand how important it is to play out of the back, to suck the other team in so you can have space in the middle. Unfortunately, they were closing down the lanes before we were getting the ball where it needed to go. So I understand. This is Quique Setién's system. He wants the players doing it. He has a philosophy. It's not going to be perfect the first time, but it still drives you crazy. Okay? Another thing to see. Right, it's about to be halftime. Messi gets his second assist. He gets the ball from a free kick, drops the ball into the box. Busquets brings it down, hits a goal. Perfect. Barcelona's going into halftime, 2-2. You're feeling good about it. I'm feeling good about it, especially as we started off so sloppy in the back. Second half, things were good, okay? They really were. It was still tied 2-2 for a while. There ended up being some subs, Junior Firpo for Jordi Alba and Vidal for Arthur. Vidal didn't have his best game. I feel like he wasn't necessarily playing that attacking midfielder role. He was actually supposed to stay set in the middle. And that's not really Vidal's, I wouldn't say it's his common position. He's either a box-to-box midfielder or he is attacking through midfielder. But it looked like he was asked to be a little bit more contained this game, as I think Sergio Roberto was supposed to own that space. Not positive, but when Vidal's told to stay committed to a certain area or a certain responsibility, he's not as dynamic as he is when he's able to break through lines on the defense or in the offense. So we're still fighting. Junior Firpo, he was given the opportunity to play against his old team. Jordi Alba came in to sub for him. But I also want to say that this was a really good time to sub him, because One thing Barcelona was having a really hard time with was getting attacked on the wings. They were getting attacked from the outside in, and the other team, Real Betis, was able to penetrate from the right and the left sides, cutting through the defenders and getting opportunities in the box. I think this was a very smart sub, right? So another, you have to give a hats off to Quique Setién as he takes out players who are not doing well. Valverde would always he pretty much had his game plan, who he was going to sub and who he wasn't. It didn't matter if you were having a bad game or not. He was going to keep the players in that he wanted in, and he was going to keep the players off the field that he chose were not going to play that day. It was different in this case. Vidal came out because his passes weren't on. He wasn't being as effective in his space, and Jordi Alba went in. He may have already anticipated getting Jordi Alba in, but he subbed him a little earlier than they probably planned because they were getting killed from the outside in. So that was hats off for me. I was really glad to see that. In the 72nd minute, there was a free kick from Messi. He drops the ball in. Lenglet heads the ball far post. Barcelona takes the 3-2 win. It was great to see. It was great to see Lenglet getting some success. You know, this game continued on to be even more dramatic, as in the 76th minute, Fekir had a double yellow for talking, right? You don't ever want to get a red card off of talking. So then he gets a red card. But Lenglet, not to be outdone by Real Betis, decides he's going to go ahead and get a foul on a double yellow and get kicked off the game. So from the 78th minute on, it's 10-on-10. Literally 10-on-10 for the rest of that game. Fine. Barcelona held in pretty good, right? Close to the 80th minute, I believe, Griezmann came out. And Rakitic was put in. I think this was just because we were 10 men down, needed more control in the middle. We were starting to get ran through, especially with that much space on 10-on-10. You want to try to close down that middle space. But one thing I did notice is that there was no threat. One of the problems we ran into from this game was that Sergio Roberto is no threat up top, right? So they were double teaming Griezmann and Messi when they were falling back. They were sprinting towards the offensive threats. But they gave Sergio Roberto space, and he was still making some bad passes. It's like he thinks pass first, take on second. And when you're trying to get a goal and you've got a breakaway and you're slowing down, waiting for others, it's a wasted opportunity. We have got to have people attacking at the top that are okay with going one-on-one to get the goal. You know, one other frustration in the game, in extra time, Messi gets the ball. He's taking it to goal, and it was a clear hand wrapped around him in the penalty box. I mean, just there's really no way to say it wasn't a penalty. Now, people used to always say Barcelona was the team that always got penalties and they were always given the benefit of the doubt and always getting penalties. Well, this is the second game in a row where clearly obvious penalties should have been awarded to Barcelona that weren't. Not only were they not, but there is VAR. What is VAR for if you're going to get, you know, you go check up VAR for Real Betis to get a handball that you didn't see, but you don't call VAR when someone's getting pulled away from the ball? Doesn't make any sense. Very frustrating. So some of the main tactical points that I want to point out was that Barcelona, I don't know if it was their strategy or not, but they were not attacking from the outside down the line. There were plenty of opportunities where I saw Junior Firpo running up the left and Barcelona chose to keep the ball in the middle. I saw a lot of opportunities on the right where even when you saw Semedo running down the side or you saw Sergio Roberto running down the right side where they could have launched the ball up to catch on, they didn't go for it. They weren't really attacking down the outside lines. In the beginning of the game, they were looking for through balls, but in the second half, they weren't really looking for those wide runs. Also, not really sure what we were doing with the hold-up play at the end in the second half. What was the hold-up play where you've got one or two on, you know, two on two, and we're holding the ball up waiting for others? We got to attack that space. We got to get some shots off. I'm not sure why we're holding up for that. Very, very, very frustrating, to be completely honest. But as far as players go, take away that red card, and literally Lenglet had a great game. Lenglet and Umtiti did a great job holding the back down. De Jong, great game. Beautiful goal. Attacked through the middle. He was a constant threat. Junior Firpo did pretty good on the left. There were some opportunities that weren't given to him. Griezmann, he was off a little today. Griezmann was off. He's having to, whenever he has to check back to pass the ball and run, usually means he's not getting the ball up top. I do think some of this has to do with the fact that Sergio Roberto was being double teamed because he's no offensive threat. So there is that. Sergio Roberto's passes were a little off. He looked like a guy who doesn't know what position he's playing anymore. Seems how every game he's playing a different role on Barcelona's squad. Could be that, honestly. Messi had a great game. 3 assists. He was making some moves. He was playing defense. He was completely solid. That ball did not want to go in for him today in the goal. But to be fair, he was attacking the space like he needed to be. So, great game. You can clearly see Barcelona misses Suarez. I don't care what anybody says. They say he's some old, aged out player. He's in his 30s. He's not good. No. Suarez, every game I watch this game, we realize what we're missing and what a revolutionary player he is. Because he's not only a real true number 9, which we don't have anymore, but he also would get a high level of assist. Now Messi's having to take that role of getting everyone else involved, where sometimes that role was Suarez. So, hats off to Barcelona. We needed this feel-good game. We really did. Talk to everyone soon.